चारशे Dear all, meeting is at capacity now. We have 500 participants on board. Please request all other members to join from the YouTube link. I'm pasting the link on the chat box as of now. Dear all, the YouTube link is on your chat box. Please pass it on to all your colleagues so that they can be with us in another 5 minutes. Thank you.
Hello, ma'am. Hello, ma'am.
Yes, hello. Tell me.
Ma'am, earlier I couldn't hear you.
Now can you hear me?
Now I can hear.
That's it. Fantastic. Okay.
Hey, Good afternoon, welcome and good afternoon to all of you, and also very great welcome to our guest speaker.
Good afternoon, sir.
We are obliged you are with us today.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. We have arranged this particular session in collaboration with Gujarat Research Society and HJ College. As I already explained to you yesterday, that HJ College has produced unlimited scholars and eminent personalities, and especially their contribution towards the creation of teachers who are the main pillar of the children and the nation. Without teachers, nothing survives in this world. Hope you must have enriched and enhanced your skill by yesterday's session. We are glad to share with you that yesterday more than 5,000 participants were there, and about 10,000 great teachers have viewed the YouTube. That is a great thing on the part of all the viewers. Now we have our very eminent and veteran Dr. Mona Bhatia is here. She is a vice principal of Nagindas Khandwala College. Her contribution is at national and international level. She is author of various publications. List of our achievements is unending. Recently, she has been awarded the Women's Achiever in logistics sector from the Logistics Sector Skill Council. So please accept our heartfelt congratulations. We are proud of you that such a person like you are with us to guide our dynamic teachers. I must share with you that all our teachers in Gujarat and Maharashtra are very devoted, very sincere, very hardworking. I must also admit they have drained themselves to impart online education during this pandemic period. We must salute all our teachers for their contribution towards the education of children. I also must share with you that this is the first time in the history of the India that two judges from Delhi High Court have acknowledged, and they have penned down in their judgment that teachers have done the noblest cause of noble cause. And first time in the history also, UNICEF also penned down the same phrases. So one can imagine the contribution being done by our great teachers. So I would not like to waste much time. I request our veteran Mona ji to take it forward, and with a request, and we are sure under your guidance our teachers will become a global change makers. They'll become powerful citizens, and also they'll become global educators. So I request Mona ji to take us forward. I am a senior citizen, but still I would like to be your student today also.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Good afternoon, everybody.
First and foremost, I would like to thank Shri Kedia ji for giving such a wonderful introduction and getting me introduced to all the lovely teachers that are present today. I would also like to thank Neelam ma'am. Without his support, it would have been possible.
See, it's not about that, but everybody has...
And Zainab ma'am for supporting me throughout. And of course, HJ College, Karuna ma'am for getting me over here. Okay, we are going to take a very interesting journey today. And we're going to learn together. The whole fun of today's is that we're going to learn together. We are going to relive some moments. We are going to learn from each other. And we're going to try to understand how can we manage our classrooms better. Let me tell you first, to give you an introduction of this topic, nobody can manage their classroom perfectly all the days. There are some days which we are very good in managing our classroom, and there are other days where we struggle to manage our classrooms, right? When we were teaching offline, that used to happen. And when we start teaching online, it is going to also happen. So there are going to be days when you're going to be proud of our lecture. We're going to come back and we're going to be so happy because our lecture was taken so well. And there are going to be other days when maybe I will not do such a good job. So it's okay. But I have to learn to improve myself every day. That is the purpose of what we call as classroom management, which we're going to learn today. So I'm just going to share my screen, and I would encourage you to use the chat box, put up questions, or maybe if you want to share your experiences, please share it. Like I said, we're going to learn together. The whole art of teaching is learning together. I hope everybody can see my slides. Are you all able to see my slides?
Yes, ma'am, we can. Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Please go back.
Yeah. Okay, like I said today, our purpose is that we are going to learn classroom management, and a lot has been spoken about classrooms and how can classrooms be managed. And let me tell you, managing classrooms is fun, and at times it can be very tough too. Like as teachers, we all understand at times it's amazing when the students listen to you, you feel very, very happy about it. And at times you feel very sad when things don't work out the way you thought. One thing that has happened, which we all became a part of, the pandemic changed the way teachers were teaching. You, me, everybody, the way we were teaching has undergone a huge change. And maybe because of this change, we came on to teach online before we were even prepared for it, right? So teachers never took online teaching seriously. I know I did not. And suddenly we are online. And look, we are so many people gathered over here today to learn from each other. And it's happening online. We never thought so much opportunity would be possible to learn online. I would like to congratulate all the teachers. I think all teachers in India have done a very good job, and they were very quick to learn online tools. They got online and they've started learning online. So they've been tremendous. They've done a very good job. Like I said, they've trained themselves to become good teachers online besides being good teachers offline. And I'm sure this journey of learning online is an everyday journey, and we all are learning new things and new tools every day. That's the beauty of online learning. Okay, I thought since I have to speak on what we call as classroom management, I thought I would take some opinions of teachers, right? Some have had good experiences, some teachers have had bad experiences. So I'm going to share with you the experiences that teachers have had teaching online. And let's try, I'm sure you will be able to associate with these experiences. Let's try to learn from each of these experiences. The first experience that I talk about is I miss interacting with my students. Okay, a lot of teachers feel online means they can't have their cameras on all the time. So the possibility of interacting with students on a face-to-face basis is minimized. So a lot of teachers fear that ye interaction nahi ho raha hai, miss ho raha hai. And definitely, I think a lot of you will identify with this, because as teachers, we were so used to interacting with students face-to-face, seeing them in the class, talking to them, finding out how life is being for them. We all definitely miss this interaction. This is a very major part that has gone missing in our lives. Next teacher said, I miss the moments of joy in class. You know, when you would joke with the students and the students would laugh at your joke. Those moments are missing online. Okay, definitely. That's a challenge too, right? Online, sometimes you joke, you're the only person laughing. Nobody laughs at your jokes. So, or you can't see them laugh, you can't hear them. That joy goes away. So yes, online has had this challenge for a lot of us as teachers as to how we are going to manage creating joy in our classrooms. Yeah. Some teachers said online interaction with students is difficult, right? They have to unmute themselves. And best thing is, a lot of students make a bahana. What is the common bahana? Network issue. Or ma'am, my camera is not working. Or ma'am, I can't unmute myself. Right? I don't know. They have so many issues. So interacting with students definitely becomes a challenge when we talk about online education. Some students say, or some teachers say, I am learning so many online tools. Okay, I am sure all of you have learned a lot of online tools. I know I have, right? Because you can't survive if you're online and you don't learn online tools. Survival is going to be very, very difficult. So we have learned a lot of online tools which we can use to make our lectures interesting and which we can use to keep what we call as the students engaged in a class. Very, very important and very positive finding, I would say, right? Out of all the maybe things we missed out, online definitely has given us one thing. It has made a lot of tools available for us to learn and to use. And even as I speak today, so many tools are coming up and are created and are made available. So there is so much to learn online as educators. Next is what teachers feel is students are not motivated to do online learning. Okay, students feel maybe online learning is not as interesting at offline. And in offline learning, what was happening, the teacher was always keeping tab of what the student was doing. In online, also the teacher is keeping, you know, she's always after this asking. I would request the participant to mute yourself, please. So, like I was saying, students are not.
नहीं ना यार.
A lot.
तुम अपनी दे देना.
Students are not motivated to learn online. So maybe we look at venues, places where we can make online teaching interesting for students. Next, some teachers said, I don't understand whether students understand. Okay, you know, I know as a teacher, we work so hard to explain. I'm telling you, teaching is tiring, right? When you deliver a lecture, you're working so hard to make the student understand the concept that you want to say, that you feel very sad if they don't understand. So in online teaching, somehow we get this feeling of unsurety as teachers and educators, whether students are understanding what I'm trying to tell them. Okay, some teachers felt my students are more productive when I teach online. Okay, some teachers felt students are doing well, they're able to focus more. They're able to finish their assignment on time. So some student teachers felt that their students have done well online. Okay, this has been online teaching for us. And thanks to the pandemic, we've experienced both sides of it. We've experienced the happy side of it, and we've experienced the sad side of it also. Right? So during this session that I have with all of you, we will try to unfold and we will try to make our lectures, our sessions, our interaction with the students more impactful. Our entire idea today afternoon to learn is, how am I going to make my class more dynamic, more interactive, more fun, more student friendly? So whether we are online or offline. And the focus of my lecture is going to be more online than offline, because I think that is where the movement is happening too. And you know, in offline classes, we have already taken offline. So we know the pros, we know the cons, we know how to manage ourselves offline. Maybe what we need to work on daily is, how do we manage ourselves online? At one end, we have the teacher. We have the teacher, and then we have the student. In offline teaching, what was happening is that the teacher and the student were at the same place. Right? We were in a beautiful, comfortable place called the classroom. So there was the teacher and there was the student. And we could directly interact with the students, and the students could directly interact with us. But online has created distance. It has created distance between the teacher and between the student. So now when a teacher wants to communicate to a student, or a student wants to communicate to a teacher, they have to figure out other ways of communicating besides face-to-face. That's why maybe emails, messaging, WhatsApp has suddenly become more important than what it was in the past. Further, what is happening is that there is a gap that is coming. And this gap is very, very worrying. Or a lot of teachers, a lot of educators, a lot of parents are very concerned about it. And even the students are very concerned about this gap that is emerging. What is this gap that is emerging? We are getting a psychological space, meaning I can't see whether the student is happy or sad. I can't see their emotions. I can't understand how they're feeling at this moment of time. So psychologically, I can't see the student. And as a teacher, if I can't see the student psychologically, I can't understand what they're going through. And that is creating mental health problems at both fronts. Teachers feel they're not doing their job well. Students feel, teacher dhyan nahi deti. And worst, it's not only a psychological space gap that is emerging, we are getting something known as an emotional space gap also. What is an emotional space gap that is emerging? An emotional space gap is a gap that is emerging because the students can't meet the teacher. Maybe they're not able to discuss the problems that they have. And because of this, they have nobody to talk to. They're not able to talk to their parents. They're not having teachers and friends available, you know, with online. You're not interacting with your classmates on an everyday basis. So again, all this is making life of students very difficult. And my dear teacher colleagues, I would like to, you know, maybe emphasize that we all need to work on the mental health of students. The word mental health today is more important than any other word. And it is very important that we talk to these students, interact with these students, so that their mental health can be enhanced and we keep them alive. Right? And that, I think, is the primary responsibility of all teachers. Please make them strong mentally. Teaching, syllabus, wo sab ho jayega. But what you have to really be working on is this mental health of your students and maybe bridging this gap. तो आप कैसे स्टूडेंट के पास आ सकते हो, उनको समझ सकते हो, उनको समझा सकते हो, that is what has to be kept in mind. This distance creates a lot of problems when we talk about online classes. Right? I hope everybody understands what I'm trying to say over here. And I'm sure we do it every day. You can identify with the problems that are coming in online classes. Okay. I feel when life gives you lemon, make lemonade. Right? So we got online classes. Great. Let's enjoy and let's learn from it. Right? Let's take advantage of it. Chronically, the bahut sari cheeze. We can keep on crying that online mein ye nahi hota, aisa nahi hota. But let's look at the benefits of it. Right? First benefit for teachers as well as students is traveling time is reduced. Now, in a city like Mumbai, traveling takes up so much time in your life. You know, I know when we used to have lectures offline, I used to often say to myself, ye traveling time bahut time le le. I could have done so much with that time if I had it. Okay, somewhere God must be listening to me, right? God heard me and God said, Mona, okay, let's reduce your traveling time and let's see what you do. So one major advantage of online teaching has been that the traveling time has reduced. Like I said, it has not only reduced for the students, it is reduced for the teacher also. So there is so much work, preparation we can do with that traveling time that we have seen. Okay, both teachers and students with online teaching, since traveling time has reduced, we get more time to spend with our families. We can sit with them, we can talk to our families, we can understand what is going on in their lives, which, like I said, with our hectic lifestyle in the metros that we are living, maybe we did not have so much time to spend with our families. So that benefit is coming both the sides. One major benefit for teachers, I feel, is you can reach a wide range of students. Look at how many teachers are together today. I mean, if this was a physical lecture done, it would be impossible to have such a diverse audience. And today, because it is online, you have a diverse audience. So, you know, a lot of my friends who are teaching languages, teaching foreign languages, tell me that they are able to take classes with students from different countries. It's not only Indian students now they're teaching. Because of online education and the growth of online education, they're able to teach people from different countries. That's a beauty, and that could have only happened because teaching is happening what we call as online. For a student, one major benefit is that flexibility into learning has come. What do we mean by that? They can learn at their pace, at their time, because some teachers are sharing videos, there are notes available online. So maybe if they did not understand the concept when it was being taught in the class online, they have time and they can go back and look at it again. That is the benefit for students also. And that's a major benefit. Students, yes, somebody would like to say something or ask something. Should I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Can the organizers tell me everything okay?
Yes, yes.
Yes, yeah. So this flexibility in learning has really been a major benefit for the student community when we are talking about online classes. And like I said, there are 100 things you can think of criticism. But let's look at the positive side and let's see how we can capitalize it, how we can use it for our institutions, our schools, to make them better. And online can teach you so much, can help you make your education style better. I'm going to touch upon two concepts which we always use when we talk about making learning happening. First is synchronous learning, and the second is asynchronous learning. Let's try to understand both these concepts well, and then we will learn how to combine them, right? Like I said, a lot of teachers feel that when they go online, the lectures are not very interactive. So we're going to look at how can we make your lecture more interactive, and we're going to touch on two concepts. Like I said, what we call as synchronous and asynchronous learning. What is synchronous learning? Synchronous learning is the teacher teaches and the student learns at the same time. Something that you and I are doing together. We are doing synchronous learning. Right? I'm talking, you're hearing me, you may ask me questions whenever you feel like. We are doing something known as synchronous learning together. We are trying to learn at the same time. And I think that is how the Indian education system has been for a very, very long time. For a very long time, we have always wanted learning to be synchronous. Saath saath mein seekhenge. But now there is a concept that is emerging in a very big way. And a lot of famous schools world over are practicing it, which is known as asynchronous learning. What is asynchronous learning? The teacher and the learner don't learn together. They learn at different times or different according to their convenience. So how does this happen? I make a video of my lecture. I upload it in an LMS platform. And all my students are present in my LMS platform. My LMS platform is my learning management system that I use. So what do the students do now? They can view my video anytime they want. And maybe after that video, I put a quiz for them. So they answer the quiz on their own and I can see the marks that they have got. So there is a lot of asynchronous learning happening. My dear teacher colleagues, this is what I would like to emphasize first. We have to not only strengthen, you know, with online teaching coming in, a lot of teachers felt we have to strengthen our synchronous teaching methodology. Yes, we have to strengthen that. That is very important. But we've always been teaching face-to-face. What we have to really work on is not the synchronous, is the asynchronous learning. How can we make it more interesting? How can we prepare more content which is available to the students even when we are not there? And that is the beauty of what we call as online learning. How much asynchronous content can you create? Whether we look at the national education policy or whether we look at the guidelines of the government in terms of education, we find that there is an emphasis on what we call as asynchronous learning coming in. Please understand me well. I am not saying that synchronous learning is not important. No. Synchronous learning is very important, but something that we have to combine, something that we have to couple with synchronous learning has to be asynchronous learning. I'm going to touch on asynchronous as we go along too. Okay, I'm sure all teachers are using some learning management system like Google Classroom, which has become very popular. A lot of teachers are using it. We have Microsoft Teams available. We have Moodle available. Our college uses Moodle as their learning management system. And there are many entrepreneurs who have created what we call as learning management systems. So there are various learning management systems available. what does a learning management system do? A learning management system doesn't teach. A lot of people feel that a learning management system is there for teaching. I'm sorry to say that. The teacher teaches. But what does the learning management system do? The learning management system supports the teacher. Right? Now, maybe all that you cannot do in your class, okay, who's going to do it for you? Or who's there to take care of that? It is your learning management system. The learning management system will figure out, will aid students, and you can make it interactive. Why can you make it interactive? Because all these learning management systems have a place where you can create, you know, query points, where queries can be typed by students and the teacher can go and answer the query. Now, you know, what's the advantage when I answer a query online? When I type the answer, it's not one student who benefits, multiple students benefit. Everybody in the learning management system sees the question, and they also see the answer that the teacher is giving. So they're not only seeing the question, they're seeing the answer that the teacher has given, and everybody learns together, right? So I have multiplied my efforts. One teacher came and told me, Mona, I love online teaching. I said, why are you saying that? Because everybody is, you know, saying they're not really enjoying it. She said, no, I love online teaching because in online teaching, I have to do an activity once. If I place it well in my learning management system, it multiplies automatically. Offline, what were we doing? If a student had a query in my subject and the query had to be answered, I would have to go to the student and I would have to solve the query. Okay, when I solve the query of one student, another student would come and ask me another query. Then I would solve the query of the other student. So I had to do the same task multiple times. Same thing, multiple times. This, okay, goes away, right? Major benefit. But you must use your learning management system well. If you don't use your learning management system well, this is not going to happen. So I would request all teachers, sit together. My dear teacher colleagues, that is how I have learned online teaching tools. We all teachers would sit together in a group and discuss with each other. How can I use these tools? How can I make the lecture more interesting? What can I do with it? Sit together and learn with each other. You know, the teaching community has to start interacting with each other. And I would like to thank the Nanavati School for creating this platform for interaction. Why is interaction needed? We learn from each other. Right? We learn from each other. One teacher is practicing one thing. The other teacher is using another tool. There can be so much learning together. I feel every teacher is a book that has a lot of information. So why not take this opportunity to learn from each other and grow together? Let's look at what my LMS system can do for me so that I understand how my learning management system is functioning. I can use my learning management system for online assignments and assessments, meaning I can assess papers online. I can give students assignment online. They can submit it to me. And the beauty of it is all my assignments are recorded at one place, right? That's the beauty of what we call as online assignment and assessment. I can share my notes, I can share my PPT with students online. So sharing and managing resources becomes very, very easy because I have a learning management system and you know, I can do it. I can incorporate videos. Now, naturally, when I'm teaching in a class, if I show a video, showing a video consumes time, right? Rather than that, I always do this. I tell students, listen, I'm going to share the video on the platform, on the learning management platform, you see the video and come. We will discuss about the video, right? So what is the benefit of that? Students get talking to each other. They discuss what is happening. And that again makes the lecture very interesting. You know, they're very excited to talk. They're very excited to tell, share what they have learned from the video. So it becomes very, very exciting to learn from each other. And the lecture becomes participative, right? My dear teacher colleagues, one thing that I have used and I've got great results is incorporating videos. Next, and when you incorporate videos in your LMS, you're doing asynchronous learning. You are teaching your students by not being present, and yet your students are learning. You can manage their grades, right? You come to know how much the student has understood, not understood. Managing grades, again, we are all the time, now when we are talking about teaching, we are talking about course outcome. What does a course outcome mean? Ye course maine tab sikhaya, what will the learner learn? So when I give them a quiz, I give them a test, I give them an assignment, I get an idea about what their grades are. So it becomes easier to manage their grades, and you can manage your students. The beauty is that you can manage all your students. All the students that have queries, they can post it over there. Like I said, you can answer, you can share your material, right? So if you're not using a learning management system, please start using one. You know, mujhe pehle lagta tha, I don't know if you felt it, we used to often feel that teachers teaching in foreign countries are better than Indian teachers. Let me tell you, teachers are teachers. Whether they teach in India or they teach abroad, teachers are teachers. But abroad, when they're teaching, their learning management system is very well defined. I love looking at the teachers' learning management system abroad. It's very well defined. Everything is in place. So when a student looks at their learning management system, the student feels confident. Teacher has taken care of everything, right? So they ensure everything is kept in place. In India, we keep all the things in our brain, right? Sab kuch andar hai. But when we manage a learning management system, we will be able to project to our students what are the resources that we have. What is in my mind gets translated into a document, gets translated into a video, and it is easily accessible. So it makes my teaching better. My LMS is my asynchronous learning. My online class is my synchronous learning. I hope I'm making sense with this. At least if one participant can unmute and tell me a yes or a no, I will know I'm going in the right direction.
Yes, ma'am.
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 Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, very, very heartwarming to
hear. Yes, ma'am.
Your voices.
Yes.
You know, for teachers, it's very, very important to hear voices back.
Yes, ma'am.
You know you're going in the right direction. And that is
yes, true, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Is going to do.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for thank you all for sharing your view also on it. And I'm sure you will go and incorporate it if you're not using it. Just moving ahead.
Mona ji, can we send a tea to you through internet?
Yes, sir.
Can we send a tea to you through internet?
No, no. I will get my own tea, sir. But thank you, sir, so much. So, you know, the way technology and artificial intelligence is coming, so maybe future mein ho bhi sakta hai. Some entrepreneur may develop a way. Why not?
Thank you, thank you.
It's a very good idea. Sir, the cup is enough. Aapne bol diya, humne chai pi li.
Thank you. So nice, sir.
Just continuing ahead, when we plan for teaching online, we are going to look at planning for teaching online in three phases. That is planning before teaching our life, during and after. So we're going to learn or we're going to understand teaching online in three phases, right? And after my session is over, you can ask me questions, you know, if you have in mind. Okay, where I feel teachers need to work more is planning before teaching online. This is the game changer. What is the difference between a popular teacher and maybe a teacher who's not so popular? If I may say, all teachers are popular in their own way. But what is the difference between a teacher who gets a lot of satisfaction in teaching and from a teacher maybe whose satisfaction is not so high is the planning that they do. So what do I do? I have the syllabus. I know this is to be taught. I sit with the syllabus and I decide what am I going to teach synchronous and what am I going to teach asynchronous. All right, my dear participants, I'd like to tell you one thing. When we talk about synchronous and asynchronous teaching, we are also talking about active and passive learning. Asynchronous teaching creates active learning on the part of the learner, right? Maine material diya hai aapko. You have to be active. You have to understand. You have to work. You have to grasp it. You have to answer the question. So the learner works. In synchronous, we have to ensure both are working together. So very, very important. Sit down with your plan. I always do this, right? And write AS for asynchronous and S for synchronous. What will you do in the class? And for what will you use asynchronous methods of teaching? Right? Very, very important. Don't do everything synchronous. Right? That's a mistake. When I do everything synchronous, I'm making a very big mistake. Don't do that. Use a combination. Use a 70-30, that means 70 synchronous, 30 asynchronous, no problem. But kuch to combination use karo. It should not happen that you only use synchronous teaching. I hope I'm clear with the first step in what we call as planning for your lecture. Next, plan for your whole lecture in advance. Lecture kal hai, ya class kal leni hai, aaj prepare karne baithoge. It's a bad idea, right? Prepare for your lecture in advance. Why? Because in online teaching, we have to use different tools. Remember, mujhe apna LMS bhi manage karna hai, phir class bhi manage karni hai, phir maybe I gave them a previous assignment, uske marks bhi dene hai. So please plan your lecture in advance. You know, students bahut fascinating hote hain. They are very fascinating individuals. They will imitate the teacher. Whether we like it or we don't like it, students imitate teachers. If teacher submits or marks, gives them marks on time, students will submit assignment on time. Right? So what is the student doing? Student is saying, I am going to behave the way teacher behaves. Right? So if teacher says, kal assignment submit honi chahiye. ओके स्टूडेंट के मन में क्या चल रहा है मैडम मार्क्स कब देगी हम तो कर देंगे कल पे एंड इन ऑनलाइन दिस गैप इज विजिबल राइट स्टूडेंट सी देयर सबमिशन एंड दे सी दैट द टीचर हैज नॉट सबमिटेड मार्क्स दे लूज ट्रस्ट माय डियर टीचर्स हम लोग क्यों काम कर रहे हैं व्हाई आर वी टीचिंग मैक्सिमम टीचर्स दैट यू टॉक टू दे से दे आर इन टीचिंग बिकॉज दे एंजॉय टीचिंग दे आर पैशनेट Right? So many interviews, I know I've sat for teachers and I'm sure Kedia sir and Neelam miss will agree with me. A lot of teachers, a lot of youngsters who get into teaching say that they are into teaching because they're passionate. But ye passion, action mein lana padega. You have to plan. Nahi to this passion is of no use. Right? Or every day you can't go to class and do a miracle. You have to plan for it. Finally, my last tip in planning before teaching. Please ask or find out which mode of online teaching is being used. you know, when I was invited today, I wanted to know which mode. Okay, if it was Zoom, I said, I know, I'm comfortable, right? I have to know which platform. Because if I don't know the platform, maybe I'll get I will not know how to use the technology. So it's very, very important to know the platform and the technology that you're going to be using for teaching. That makes your work easier and you look smooth. And like I said, students are great observers. वो चीज भी ऑब्जर्व करते हैं जो आपने नहीं बोली होती, राइट? वो पकड़ लेते हैं कि ये टीचर को ये नहीं आ रहा, शी इज स्ट्रगलिंग. यू नो मेनी अ टाइम्स व्हेन आई गिव द क्विज, नो दे विल टेल मी, मैम एक्सेस नहीं मिल रहा है, वी आर नॉट एबल टू एक्सेस द क्विज. देन आई टेल देम, डोंट वरी, लॉग आउट, लॉग इन अगेन, यू विल बी. सो नाउ दे नो, मैम को मालूम है ये, हाँ आता है इनको. इनिशली मुझे नहीं आता था, आई यूज टू गेट वेरी नर्वस. Right, then I started practicing whatever tool of online teaching I was going to use with them beforehand, and then going to class, because they will imitate you. Difference between teachers abroad, good teachers and bad teachers, let me say that, or teachers who are more effective and less effective. Teachers who are more effective plan more. Teachers who are not that effective lack in their planning. Okay, I hope the planning stage was clear and it brought to light all the things that you have to keep in mind while you're planning for the lecture. During the lecture, you need clarity. Clear hona chahiye, simple and clear. You know, the teachers that you remember are the teachers who taught you simply. Simple tha, bahut simple tha, and bahut clear tha. Right, whether you're teaching mathematics, chemistry, physics, biology, commerce, geography, history, each subject, the student just wants clarity. And if as a teacher, I'm able to deliver my content clearly, the student will start enjoying the subject. Right? Why will they start enjoying the subject? Because they understand. You know, one of the most beautiful feelings in life is when we understand. And that is for every human. And students are humans. Don't forget that. So they will feel wonderful when they understand. And that is what you have to be in your presentation. You have to be clear. Okay, a tip I feel is very important. And I'm sure a lot of you teachers must be following it also. It's not something invented by me. It is there, but it's some do it, some don't do it. Greeting students online. Offline, the thena, we could smile at them. They would understand. Online, if I say good morning, everybody, okay, everybody feels like nobody. Matlab unko lagta hai, the teacher is not greeting us really. Okay, calling their names is wonderful. When I say maybe good morning, Monica, good morning, Lena, calling their names does miracles. And that is what we have to do when we are taking our lectures, greeting students with their names or asking students questions with their names is very, very important, because they feel the teacher cares. When you call a student by their name, you're indicating that you care about them. Calling these students by their name indicates that. Don't only teach. 5 minutes class mein aise bhi hone chahiye where you share your experience. Mere saath aisa hua, right? And I think that is where learning happens. You know why you should share your experience? When you share your experience, unke kaan khul jate, their ears open up and they're interested in what you're saying because it's funny. They realize, acha, teacher is also human being. Unke saath bhi ye problem hoti hai. I shared with the class once how, you know, I exited myself from my own class and all the students were inside, and by mistake, I pressed the leave button and I was out of my class and I continued teaching. Then after 10 minutes, I realized I'm not in my own class, right? So it's very important to share your experiences with them. So they feel online teacher ko bhi difficulty ho rahi hai. So they start cooperating more and we learn together. Like I said, the whole idea is to make learning interesting. Take regular feedback. You can take you can make a small Google form, give it to your class, take regular feedback. And in the 21st century, in pandemic age or in post-pandemic age, one thing that makes a lot of difference is student opinion. Maybe sometimes students, when they give feedback, and I'm aware of it, I say it with full awareness, when they give feedback, maybe the feedback may not be correct, right? But whether we like it or we don't like it, student opinion matters. We have to at least decide what feedback we are going to take seriously and what feedback we are not going to take seriously. Look, after I finish the lecture today, you will all give me feedback. And I will take your feedback very seriously. Because if I have to grow as a teacher, I have to learn to respect my students. I have to listen to what they have to share with me, right? And it is, growth of a teacher can only happen through taking feedback from students seriously. I'm going to share some questions that maybe you can put in a feedback form and you can ask students to share with you. Are you comfortable using technology online? Okay, it's very important to find out whether students are comfortable using technology online. Okay, have you encountered any technical issues? Okay, very important to find out the problems they are having with technology, right? Many a times things are okay with us at home. Maybe they are facing a problem with technology. Let's try to understand what is the problem that they are facing. Okay, are my assignment and lectures clear? Very important. Dekho, we are using an LMS, right? Maybe unko samajh mein nahi aa raha kaise dekhna hai. You know, many a times students ko technology se sirf teachers ko sirf technology se difficulty nahi hoti hai. Students also struggle with technology. So I must find out whether they are able to understand or not. Are you able to hear my voice? All right. Are you able to voice your opinion in class? Online, no. Voicing opinion is much easier. Chat window pe likh do, kaam ho jata. Right. But are they able to do that or do they feel shy? Right. If they don't respond on the chat window, sometimes I go with roll numbers by heart or names by heart. And I say, in logo ko to main poochne wali. And then one question that must be asked always. How can I make my online classes better? That is a question that you have to ask. You have to find out reasons and you have to find out ways rather, not reasons. You have to find out ways of making your online classes better. I hope this feedback form is useful to you and I encourage you to use this feedback form in your classes. Okay, like I said, our lecture is, or our process for preparing for online lectures is divided into three parts. We had before, we had during, and we had after. Like I said, planning before your lecture was very important. After your lecture is done, what the work that you have to do is also very important. Implementing concrete suggestions given by the students, very important. Okay, I'd like to share an incident of mine. For conducting quizzes, what we have started doing now with online teaching, we conduct a quiz after each chapter, right? So we get an idea how much the students understand, where which concepts are they finding it difficult, etc. So I started using multiple tools to conduct a quiz. Sometimes I would, whatever online tool I would learn, I would use it with them. So the students gave me a feedback and said, ma'am, it will be better if you use one tool because we get confused when you use multiple tools. Now that was a very good feedback. I felt it was a very good feedback. I, in my enthusiasm, I was using multiple tools, But I did not realize that the students were finding it difficult. I implemented that suggestion for that class. And each class differs, no? Some students like multiple tools. So for them, I use it. For those class who don't like it, I use the tools that they have. If you promised you will share notes with them, please share notes with them, right? If you're going to share material, share notes, please make sure that you give it to them. Because now they can't go to college, they can't go to the library. So I think sharing material with them at this moment of time is more important than any other time. So you must fulfill your promises to them. Assess assignments on time and give written feedback, right? They love it when a teacher gives written feedback. I know sometimes in our classes, our numbers are so large. Okay, sometimes if you're not able to give written feedback, at least assess the assignments on time. And then maybe when you have your class, you can discuss these were the areas where you made mistakes or you need to improve on. Today, nobody likes the word mistake. Everybody wants, positive words to be used. So you can go ahead and tell them these are the areas or where improvement can be made. Okay, I'm going to pause a little over here and I'm just going to let you absorb. I hope everybody's okay with this process of before, during, and after the lecture. Dear participants, can you unmute and tell me, are we okay till here?
Yes, ma'am. By all means. By all means.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Very informative.
Yes, ma'am. Very good.
Yes, ma'am. Good.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much.
Really, very good.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Very good.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Thank you. Ma'am, I just wanted to share.
Yes,
your feedback form is a wonderful idea, ma'am. I will surely implement that idea, ma'am.
Yeah, please share it and then it will be better. Yes, then it gets better with that. Okay, I have some things that you must keep in mind too.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, please remember, students don't engage with the computer. Unko computer se pyar nahi hai. Unko teacher aur apne students se pyar hai, apne colleagues se. So when you may do online classes, let them interact with each other. And that is what all research papers are pointing at, that we must encourage students to interact with each other. Ek dusre se baat kare, ek dusre se seekhe, teacher se baat kare. Because what has happened with online teaching is, with online teaching, social skills come away. Right? Offline teaching, one major merit of offline teaching was the social skills. With online teaching, social skills come ori, right? So since social skills come ori, we have to create assignments which make them talk. We have to ask them questions, create assignments. We have to push them to talk. Or if they don't talk, chat window pe type kar. But that has to be done because we have to enhance their social skills. And you know, when our social skills fall, mental health issues hote hain, right? Because I have not spoken, mere jo dil mein tha, dil mein reh gaya, mental health issues start. So we have to make our classes interesting and interactive. That is a very important keyword. Things we must do is, we must promote students to be independent. Right? I always tell students, online to online, there are many benefits. Learn to learn yourself. Right? That is, look, a teacher today is a mentor. She can help you. She's a facilitator or he's a facilitator. They can help you. Please promote what we call as independent behavior in students. Tell them to be independent learners. Right? If they become independent learners, the advantages, your results will improve. Marks, jabardastane lagenge bachon. And who doesn't want that, right? We want our students to do well. I'm telling you, world over, Indian students, jaise koi students nahi hai. They're very sharp. Hum kitna bhi kuch bhi bol de inko, Indian students are very, very sharp. And they have a desire to learn, right? But we have to promote this desire of learning in them. Use flipped classroom. This is a new terminology that is going around in teaching, and it is very, very popular. At least in colleges now, it is becoming very popular. Flip mein kya kar rahe hai? I don't teach in the class. I share my PPT on my LMS with the students. Right? Small topic. Don't take a big topic. Small topic. I share my PPT with the students. Or I share a content, an article, maybe written by somebody famous on the LMS. And I tell the students, read the article and come. When they come to the class, we discuss the article. Right? So I don't teach that topic, teach. Normal nahi. PPT dikhaya, padhaya. Nahi. We discuss. So that is again something that you must do. Use flipped classroom. There the learning is active. Remember active passive we spoke about? So when you use flipped classroom, the learning of the students is what we call as active. And encourage interaction. Encourage interaction. That is very important. Like I said, if you feel unmuting of mic bots zyada ho raha hai, sometimes it becomes troublesome, right? Chat window use kar, but encourage interaction. Or you have your LMS system also. Tell them, listen, maybe I cannot answer all your questions right now. You can always post it in the chat window. Or maybe you have a WhatsApp group of students. They can post their questions, you can answer that. But encourage this. Answer the questions. Online mein hume difficulty ho rahi hai, to students ko bhi difficulty ho rahi hai. Like, please keep it in mind. Look, they're studying at home. To unko bhi ghar ka kaam mein bhi karna padta hoga. Which when they were coming to college, they were not doing. So understand the difficulties the students are also facing. And then, whatever way you can sort it out. Do it, but do encourage them to talk and interact with you. You should not feel I'm emphasizing too much on that, but you know, all reports coming out by government, World Health Organization are telling educators that they have to encourage interaction. That's why I'm stressing on it. Okay, things not to do, very, very important. Don't compare online with offline teaching. Ye hum discussion kar ke. You know, we become negative in our approach. Right? Like I said, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. So look at the positive. Don't look at the negative. Don't compare yourself with other teacher. Ye teacher ne aise kiya. Maine aise kiya. Usne aise kyun kiya. Do what you think works for you and your personality. We all have different personalities, right? Ek person koi aur cheez mein achcha hai, main koi aur cheez mein achhi hu. So don't get into this comparison rat race. That's a very wrong thing. And here when we compare, I mean with online as well as offline. Create your own style. Create your own style of educating people because that's the best style. And suppose we are all human beings in the end of the day. Suppose you make a mistake online. Let's suppose. Hogi galti. It's okay. Sabke saath hota hai. Right? We all make mistakes.
Ghazala, Irfan ko bula boli.
Right? So learn from your mistakes and forgive yourself. Don't be too hard on yourself. Don't neglect yourself. You know, a lot of teachers tell me, man, kaam itna bad gaya hai, pura din hum log lage rehte hain. No, at least 30 to 40 minutes a day, take out for yourself. Walk pe jao, family ke saath chai piyo, enjoy karo, friends se baate karo. Right? Take out some time for yourself. Don't be doing online all the time. Refresh yourself. You know, in psychology, there's this beautiful term they use. They call it burnout. What is burnout? Matlab main itna thak gaya hu that now I can't work further. Right? Online teaching mein burnout hona bahut easy hai. We can easily reach this stage of burnout. You have to save yourself from this burnout. And to save yourself from burnout, you must love yourself and spend time with yourself. That is very, very important, so that things go the way that you wanted them to. Okay, I have a question that I'm going to pose to all of you, and I will request only one, two, three participants to unmute themselves and answer this question. Do you think technology can replace teachers?
No, ma'am.
Okay, no, yes, polna easier. Tell me the reason. I want to know the reason why.
According to me, ma'am, hi, I'm Sujata Tiwari from Pawa Public School. I am teaching in primary classes, ma'am. So according to me, when a teacher is teaching to their students, at that time, whatever bonding we are creating and whatever love we are creating with the with each other, that can be not replaced by the technology. First thing, and how you are telling whatever things you are just now you are telling, the all things we are applying in our...
Thank you, Sujata, for sharing that. Anybody else would like to share?
Yes, ma'am. I would like to share my view. Yeah, my name is Hetal. I'm from Trinity International School. Technology cannot replace teachers, because if a student is looking at a video, he will understand on his own way. If he wants to ask question that time, so he cannot ask it. And if a teacher is teaching and interacting with a student when the class is going on, whatever comes in his mind, he can get it cleared that time only. Whereas here, he can see on his own that time. And then later on, if he gets to interact, then he can do it. Otherwise, he will understand whatever he comes to know. So that is a lot of that makes a lot of difference here.
Okay, I agree.
So that
Ruth Fernandez from Campion School.
Yes, makes more
I would like to just say that human touch is more important because of empathy, feelings which are shared. Looking at a blank thing does not give you that human touch, that empathy, that love which we can show to the child. Give him a hug, give him some praise. He loves it. Thank you.
Ruth, ma'am, I totally agree with you. I totally agree with you.
Ma'am, can I share?
Please, please, please do.
I'm Vijayta Trikha from Arya Vidya Mandir, Juhu, Mumbai. I feel like technology can assist a teacher to make a lesson interesting, but it cannot replace the teacher, because the emotional touch which the teacher can give by her physical presence, that cannot be done via technology. Thank you, ma'am.
Madam, may I say, thank you for sharing that.
Please, madam.
Yes, please, ma'am.
Yeah, I'm Aynapurni Venkateshwaran from IES Manik Vidya Mandir, Bandra Reclamation. I feel that technology can replace the IQ of the teacher, but technology cannot replace the EQ.
All right. A very nice perspective of looking at it. Thank you, ma'am, for sharing this perspective. Very nice perspective of looking at it. Anybody else would like to share?
I would like to say, ma'am.
Yes.
I'm Roshan Agarwal from Nanavati School, Villeparle.
Yes, Roshan.
I feel that we have a variety of children. Some are very bright, some are average, some are below average also.
Yes.
In one way, we cannot cater to all the children. So technology has one way to play, but teacher can touch each and every heart. So she can cater, she can change her teaching attitudes from one child to the other.
Very nice, very nice. Brilliant.
Very yes, true, ma'am. Very true.
Very true.
I too agree.
Anjana, ma'am, may I?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, my name is Anchal Verma. I'm from Pawar Public School. Actually, what I want to say is technology is the outcome of human mind.
Right.
And in order to understand the human mind, I think will be a better person to reach to the children.
Yes.
And also to understand actually what is happening in that young, innovative mind, that we can look after that and cater the need.
Anjal, thank you for sharing that. Anybody else?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I am Nirupama Kalyanpur from Aspi Nutan Academy.
Right.
What I would like to share is we teachers are more than just facilitators of knowledge. we can yes. guide as a mentor, inspiration, which cannot be done by a device. Okay. And there are human skills like decision making, time management, which a child needs. No, wherein the teacher will inculcate it day in and day out, be it the class teacher or the subject teachers. So here is where the human skill comes into the picture. The teacher plays a very, very crucial role.
Excellent, excellent. I'm so
yes,
happy.
Ma'am. Even okay. I want to add something.
Yes, yes, please. Yes.
My name is Prajakta Fadde from Visenji Academy.
Yeah,
and I just want to add that, ma'am, I have observed that whenever we are in live classroom, at that time, by looking at the student's face, we can change the strategies of our teaching. So that's very important here. Like in online classes, that's a little bit difficult for us. And yeah. then I have also observed, like even my students nowadays, they are telling me instead of sharing PPT, miss, please teach us directly from board or from whiteboard.
They're missing the board.
So yeah. They are missing instead of this presentation and all. They they just want to discuss
see handwriting.
Yeah. That's it. Ma'am. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Sharad sir.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, can I share?
Please do that. Please do that.
Ma'am, myself, Monica Dhadij, New Model English High School. Ma'am, I want to say that whenever the teacher is present in the class before,
yes,
she was interacting with the students.
Right.
But that time when the children used to see the teacher, they were feeling so happy, and that happiness is not there. The technology will not give them so much happiness, ma'am.
Right, right. Okay. Anybody
ma'am,
else?
Can I share, ma'am?
Please.
Yes, ma'am. Sharad Chiridhaukar from Power Public School, Dombivli. All teachers are talking about the academic lectures, but co-curricular activities are there. The children are very, that activity they are missing, like physical education, then dance, and then drama.
Yes.
And actually, that activity makes a perfect child because these qualities are there, some qualities are there by this subject. Now what happens, some schools are, as per my knowledge, some schools are not organizing the classes in as a normal timetable.
Right.
They are missing that also. That is also very important.
I agree. Anything that, you know, requires teaching a skill, face-to-face makes a lot of difference. Right? Face-to-face makes a lot of difference. Thank
yes.
you for such a wonderful interaction. And I liked each and everybody's perspective about technology and teachers. Right? I would just like to put my perspective also in. Technology definitely can't replace a teacher. Right? We will always need a teacher no matter how developed technology becomes. There can't be a substitute for a teacher.
Right, madam, right.
But teachers yes, ma'am. Who use technology and teachers who don't use technology, there will be a differentiation. Right? And that is what we have to keep in mind. Right now, in the present, why say the future? In the present, we can classify teachers into two groups. Teachers who use technology and teachers who don't use technology. And my dear colleagues, we all have to be in the group of teachers who use technology. Right? This is also something that we have to understand. It is not going to go, it is not going to be like the past. No. It is not going to be like. Whether we like it, we don't like it, we are comfortable with it, we are not comfortable with it. But we have to get technologically savvy. That is becoming very important. And it's not only happening in education. It's happening in all the sectors. Right? All sectors, technology is coming in a big way. And one sector where education is coming in a big way too is education. Some precautions that you should take while teaching online. Select your background well. Right? Select a background where nobody can go behind you. You know, a lot of students, suppose you're sitting in the dining table, and I have seen these incidences, and somebody in the family passes by behind. So the students are not interested in what the teacher is doing. The students are interested in what is going on behind the teacher. right? So you have to choose your background well. And I always tell teachers, take a background where nobody can go behind you, so that you don't have this problem of they looking at who's in your family and what they're doing, right? One colleague of mine was teaching in a class, and a man came with a cup of tea and gave it on a table. And the students started typing on the chat window, "Ma'am, is he your husband?" Right? So students like such gossip, and you know, they want to talk. So to avoid that, select your backgrounds well. Be careful when to switch off and on your camera. I feel as teachers, students can't on their camera all the time, but you should on your camera. They should be able to see your expressions. That is very important. They should be able to see how you are talking, right? How you are dressed, whether you're formally dressed or not, because it makes an impact on them. And be careful when to mute and unmute. Very important, right? If somebody in the family, look, we are all teaching from home. Some family member comes and wants to tell you something. Be careful whether your mic is muted or unmuted. These are some precautions that you must take when we talk about online classes. So if I were to conclude all that we have discussed today in managing classes online, what does it require? It requires three P's, that is planning, planning, and planning. The more you plan, the more interesting your lectures are going to be, and more appreciative they will become. Conclusion, be sensitive to pandemic, na aapne bulaya, na maine bulaya, aa gaya. Right, so we have to understand if we are facing difficulty, so are the students at this time. It's very, very important that we keep this perspective in mind, that it's not only us who face a problem, it's them too. Effective time management, very important. That time that you spend with the students doing synchronous learning in classroom, spend it well. Decide what you're going to do. Don't just let time go and you don't achieve the objectives that you wanted to achieve for your course, right? So effective time management definitely has to come in. A beautiful saying I read, which I thought I should share with all of you: all the armies of the world cannot stop an idea whose time has come. My dear teacher friends, the time for online education is here. Like I said, we cannot stop it from coming up. It is here and it is here to stay. But what I can do is I can start learning it. I can start adapting it. I can start accepting it. That is what I have to do. Because it's here. Anyway, it's here. Aur kitne mahine hum log criticize karenge isko, right? And so let's start adapting. Let's start learning. Let's look at the advantages so that it can help us grow. And we can grow together. That is the beauty of managing classes online. Thank you. If you have any questions from your side, I will
be more than happy to take it. Ma'am, I wanted to say something, ma'am, if you don't mind. I find children today have no more technology than us.
I'm not able to hear you very well. Can you just be a little louder?
Children of today know more technology than teachers of today. So some of them are like our gurus. They teach us of certain things which we are not aware of. Right. And it really helps us a lot.
No harm in learning from us. I mean, there's no harm in learning from students. But we should at least know as much as they do. Or a little less than they do in technology. But not learning at all, that is where it is right now. Yes. Any other questions? Thank you so much.
There's a polling facility. There's a polling facility at the end of a lesson, which I've realized that also is important. because at the end of a lesson, one can do polling to find out if the children have understood a topic immediately after your class.
Excellent. It's a superb tip, ma'am. And even I'll try that out. Okay, I've got a fun game for you since if there are no more questions. And
ma'am,
I have...
excuse me, ma'am, I can add one more thing. Many of them, they are saying about teachers and all. One thing is, teacher can decide task how students want to learn. Means if they are finding difficult to learn, so we can go one step back and we can think about the child, how it can be changed, how that syllabus or what the lesson we are teaching, it can be changed. So it's in our hand how to improve teaching. I'm Vivekanand Mhatre from IAS Orange School, but I listen to every one of you, but I thought this will be the different way where we will be handling our students.
It's an excellent tip. It's an excellent tip shared with us, Mhatre sir, and definitely worth implementing.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Thanks a lot.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Can I share with you something?
Yes,
I am Arti Mishra from New Model School. I want to talk about a very wonderful person who taught me the planning. He is Mrs. Munim ma'am from Nanavati School. And I learned a lot of things from her. How to plan and how to be very positive towards the education I learned from her. So I really want to mention that. And same
thank
thing I learned from
thank you for sharing that. You know, Aarti, mujhe bhi lagta hai, when we see a teacher, no, we realize. Because teachers look very friendly, sweet, happy. And that is very important. Tabhi bachche aayenge hamare paas.
Yes, ma'am. Really.
Thank you, Aarti, for sharing this.
Thank you.
Okay, like I said, I've got a small flashcard game. So I'm going to share that with you. And let's learn more. I never leave students. When I get a chance, I feel I should, do 100%. So we're going to do flashcards and I will request, Lina, can we start with you first? Okay, yes, anybody would volunteer?
Yes.
Lina, can we start with you? Monica, can we start with you?
Yes.
Okay, all right. I'll tell you what you have to do in these flashcards. What you have to do in the flashcards is two statements are given, right? There is nothing like right and wrong. You have to choose the statement that you agree with. Monica, you will read the statement and tell me which statement you agree with.
It is important for students to see my face when I teach online. I agree.
Okay. So you feel being visible and the face being shown online is more important than communication skills online?
Yes.
Okay. First, okay. And please, can you tell me?
Then they see the expression of the teacher.
Yes.
And they understand well.
Excellent.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Sarika Thakkar.
Yes, Sarika.
Both the things, it's both important. Seeing the
face. But if I had to choose. If I had to choose one.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Yes, Sarika, the question is one. We know both is important. Life mein hamesha both hi important hota hai. But if I had to choose one, Sarika, what would you choose? Okay, Sarika has given me a tick mark, I guess. Okay.
May I? I'm Maya Gowda from Shishuvan School.
Yes.
I feel that the second option I would go with. The most important factor in online teaching is my communication skill. How I communicate to the child is more important because that is the actual outcome, you know, of the teaching.
Absolutely. But, you know,
I second her, ma'am. I second her because, sometimes technology, if you keep your videos on, the strength which is used is more. So that hampers the listening skill also, the audio also. Right. So better to go for the second option, I feel.
All right. Thank you.
Ma'am, I feel the first option is that when the children is in school,
the interaction is different. The children understand well, they enjoy well, they interact well with the class environment.
Right.
But as compared to the communication skill, which is done online, children are learning the various methods of learning. But the interaction session and the class environment is missing.
Fantastic. Both points taken. Like I said, it's a perspective. There is nothing right and wrong about it. Let's go to the next statement. Okay, who would like to take up the next? Aarti, would you like to take it up? Aarti Veldi?
Yeah, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I chat with students and solve the problem. Queries and students are better solved. Ma'am, I go for second one because queries of students are better solved face to face, ma'am.
Ma'am, I don't know who is this speaking. You were telling me, right? You were addressing Aarti Velde, if I'm not wrong.
Yes, that's right.
Somebody else must have answered, ma'am. I don't know who answered.
Sorry, my name
is... No problem. Aarti, you can get in your perspective also.
Yeah.
Aarti, are you going to say what's your answer?
Ma'am, I will go for second answer because queries of students are better solved face to face, ma'am.
All same right. Year, ma'am. This is Aarti Velde from IAS Manik Vidya Mandir. I feel second option is better, ma'am. It will all go right. Better for me.
Okay.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Ma'am, this encourage you to look at online query solving too, right? Please understand, you can multiply your effort, but meaning you answered it once, multiple students can get the benefit out of it. Okay, I agree, face-to-face, it solves for one student. FAQs, frequently asked questions, so that everybody gets the benefit. Right? It is a suggestion.
Agree, ma'am. Agree.
It is a suggestion. Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Look at it. We will move ahead. Rachna Suraj, will you take the next one?
Students find studying online boring. Students are motivated to self-learn online.
Students find studying online boring. Students are motivated,
to self-learn online.
Which one do you agree
second
with?
One. Agreed with second one.
Okay. As teachers, we really feel, you know, students should be motivated to learn online rather than getting bored online. Now they don't have a choice to. So I guess if they enjoy learning online, it would work better for both the teacher as well as the student. And I think, yes?
Ma'am, I feel whether if the teacher is teaching online also, still it is on the teacher how she plans or how she inculcates the method of teaching during online for the children and how the children find it easier to interact with the teacher. It is on the teacher how she interacts well with the different methodology of teaching. It is on her that through online also she can make her lesson interesting.
I agree with you completely. Right? It depends a lot on the teacher, how she motivates her students. Then it doesn't matter whether you're online or offline. We're going to take the next one. Namita, would you like to take it up, please?
I give clear instruction to my students for assignment. I'm open for association.
Namita, would you like to take it up or Rajitri?
Can I?
Yes, please do.
Namita here.
I give clear instruction to my students for assignment. I am open to association.
Ma'am?
Yes.
I'll go with the second option. I'm open for
suggestions from students.
Okay. All right. Anybody who will go with the first option?
Ma'am, yes. May I say?
I give clear instruction. Even the first option is also right.
Can I speak?
Yes.
Ma'am, can I speak?
Please.
Hello. Yes, ma'am. I'll go with the first option because if I'm the well planned with my assignment, I will give the clear instruction to the students so that they can do the assignment properly. If I give them options, option, they suggest me, and then according to that, I'll plan my assignment. It will be the flop then.
I guess, ma'am, all of above is the right option.
That always is. But you know, the whole idea is to get you to choose. Life is always gray, let me tell you. Even for teachers, it is always gray.
Very right? True, even, ma'am, very true.
Even I prefer giving clear instructions, rather than taking suggestions all the time, because I feel suggestions take up too much time sometimes, right? And we lose focus. Maybe when you have a small class, suggestions make sense. But if it is a big class, clear instructions works.
Yes, agree to.
Let's look at the next one. Anybody would like to take it up?
Can I?
Yes, please.
Students make excuses with technical difficulties faced during online lectures. Students do not respond to my queries. First one, ma'am.
Yeah. We all have experienced it a lot.
Yes, first.
Right?
Yes. First one.
But at least it's better than the second one. In the second one, if they don't respond, I'm not going to get anything. In the first one, at least they're responding to me. So that is very nice. Very clear winner. Over here. Next we have.
Can I?
Yes, please do.
Rehana from U.S. Oswald School, Mira Road. Teaching online is not a satisfying experience. Teaching online gives me great satisfaction.
Second one, ma'am.
Excellent.
Yes, ma'am.
So second. You're all contemporary teachers. That means you're ready to adapt, ready to learn, ready to change, ready to grow. Yes. Fantastic. I love the response to this.
Ma'am, I just wanted to share something. Please, you know, please. The terminology which I have learned from my student is, you must have heard about photo bombing, like somebody's video taking a selfie.
Yes.
Like this, they taught me there is something called audio bombing and video bombing, ma'am. You know?
Okay. All right.
So this is what I've learned from my students.
Right. I was not also aware about it. Thank you for teaching me that too.
Yes, ma'am. My pleasure.
Yes. Next statements. Anybody?
Ma'am, the first one, I think.
Ma'am, the first one. My knowledge has increased.
My knowledge has increased by teaching.
First one.
I feel very happy when I know all these tools. I'm telling you, it gives me a lot of satisfaction. Right? I also go totally with the first statement. I feel online has really taught us all as a community a lot. And we
knowledge is increased.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Yes. And now we feel we can manage both the ways. We can manage online as well as offline.
And offer.
Yeah, that has been brilliant about it. Yes, the next one.
Yes. I find it easy to manage.
Ma'am, can you just remove these annotations? It's very difficult to read.
I find it easy to manage classes online.
It is very important.
I enjoy teaching offline.
Yes.
Both are important.
I find it easy to manage classes online.
And enjoy teaching offline. Both are important.
Yes, that's right.
Yes.
Both are important.
Yeah, both are important.
Yes, both are important.
Each, I think a blend is that what we are looking at.
Yes.
Yes, next statement.
Look at this.
Can create a lot of
notions
online.
Students are
going to learn.
The second one, and even the first one.
Initially, when classes started online, we all faced problems with students. Right? Then, now,
yes.
It has subsided. Right?
Yes,
in the newspaper also, we would see a lot of articles coming out as to how teachers are facing a tough time with students. Initially, there was a lot of nuisance online. Now, I think it's, you know, they've understood, we have understood. So I think the balancing is happening right now. All right.
I want to start teaching in physical mode. I want
the first one.
Okay.
Physical mode.
All
ma'am,
right.
If the situation is not good, then we have to continue in the online.
Online class. The situation becomes better. The first one option is better, ma'am.
But I think as teachers, we are all teachers.
Supposed to leave the teaching.
Ma'am, excuse me, a blend of the annotations.
Yeah, that is what blended learning is called, right? Again, a new concept which is coming in a very big way, where you teach offline as well as you teach online.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Can we stop the annotations? It is really difficult to read otherwise.
Yeah, I can't do that. I will request the organizers if you can stop this.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay, who would like to take this up?
I have to put them more on online lecture.
Can I? The first one, ma'am.
First one, ma'am.
The first one, ma'am.
First one.
More for online.
First one. First one.
Present the children.
Okay, but you know, we are more systematic.
But we have to prepare for both.
Yeah, but when we prepare for online, we prepare a lot of written content. When we are preparing a lot of written content online, we automatically become more systematic. That's what I have felt.
Agreed.
That's it from my side. Now, if you have any questions, I leave it to you. Otherwise, I would like to thank everybody for the opportunity given to me.
I'll just call sir. Sir would like to speak to you and sign off. So may I just please call Kedia sir for a minute?
Yes, please, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Just hold on for 2 minutes. We'll be back with you.
Ma'am, it was a wonderful session and we thoroughly enjoyed it.
Thank you so much.
Very interactive and we learned a lot, ma'am. We learned a lot from you. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, and you were very sweet, ma'am. Very sweet.
Thank you.
Ma'am, absolutely love this session, ma'am.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Great
session.
We really enjoyed and we really loved it.
Nice session, ma'am.
Thank you so much. I loved interacting with all of you. And I go back with very good memories. And I am so confident that India is in such good hands as we have such lovely.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
I think Milani, mute everybody, then we can talk.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Teachers, please mute yourselves.
Hello, sir. When is next session?
1 minute, ma'am. 1 minute. Just let us finish. We'll let you know.
Wait, huh? Hope everyone must have enjoyed or enriched or imbibed ocean of knowledge during this second day of the session. Excellent, wonderful session by Mona ji. So we are obliged to her. All of you are knowing that hybrid education will continue. It's not going to stop maybe few years. People are telling 1 year. In my opinion, it's going to continue few years. That means unless you become expert digitally, I think none of us will be able to survive. Our grandchildren will be better off than us unless we learn digital things, that too under the guidance of Mona ji. We pay our gratitude to Mona ji for sparing her valuable time and enriching our young dynamic teachers. We always look forward to have your guidance regularly, so that nobody erases your teaching methods, what they have learned. The human mind, it gets erased. So we have to keep adding in the minds of everybody, including myself. Once again, we pay our gratitude to Rajiv Ji, who is the founder, who is the founder member of the GRS, Gujarat Society, and the HJ College, for arranging such a veteran guest speaker, Bona Ji. Training session, daily. This training session really has helped or helping our young teachers. Dear dynamic teachers, our next session will be on 26th and 27th, same timings. I only request you, please have your, do not have heavy lunch so that you don't sleep during between 2 and 4. So have a light lunch, so remain active, otherwise you will be missing the valuable guidelines from the person like Mona Ji and other guest speakers. We hope, we only pray to God, you remain safe and healthy. You are the future of our children and our nation. God bless you. Once again, thank you, Mona Ji. We are personally obliged to you for your sharing such a wonderful experience.
Excuse me, sir. Knowledge. Excuse me, sir. Could you please repeat when is the next session? I'm sorry, I missed it.
26th and 27th.
Next Friday and Saturday, ma'am. Next Friday.
Okay, thank
and
you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
So, Mona Ji, I must admit, as a student at my age also, I have learned a lot of new things from Mona Ji. I said, I promise her, I will also try to implement such learning thing, such teaching methods to our dear teachers.
Sir, same code.
Excuse me, sir. Link is same or what, sir? Hello?
Code, sir.
We will inform you, my dear teacher. Don't worry. We will, otherwise you will fail us. We'll provide you YouTube link. We'll provide you Zoom link. We're very afraid of all of you. Then you will give us less marks. So,
and I'll just come in. So the links are the same. Teachers, the ID and the password is the same. The YouTube link is a permanent live link now. So there'll be no changes in that. It'll be very easy for you to know.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sir, I just want to know one thing. As you said in the introduction, that this whole thing was arranged by Gujarat Research Society's HJ College. Is it at Khar? Is that so?
Yes, it's Khar only. Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Our office. Anandi School Forum office is Jesuit Van School.
Yes, yes, sir. So that's what I was part of both. So I was quite curious to know. I had taught 20 years at Jesuit Van School, and that's how I did my BA through HJ College. So that's how I came to know. Okay, I mean, I was so curious to know that. Okay, is it the same or what?
Because we know you did your BA from there, but you're forgotten
No, I didn't forget. I wanted to confirm. I didn't forget. Otherwise, I wouldn't have said.
No, we are refreshing your memory, so you become one more student of HJ College.
Thank you. that brought smile on my face, going back, flashback, you know.
Yeah.
That's all. Sir, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Just let me clarify one thing. All those on YouTube link, you'll get your certificates, please. I'll put it on the chat box. Please check whether you are here or on YouTube. you will get your certificate from the USF. Please don't worry.
Ma'am, it is not about our certificates. I just wanted to know, can we get a recorded sessions like in the future, for the future use, if possible?
Yes, sir. I think we will discuss among ourselves. Our executive committee will take it forward. We'll try to do that.
Thank you, teacher.
It will be really helpful, sir, if we are using it for the future also.
Sure. You are our future, so we have to do something for
you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Teachers, we may end the meeting with your permission, please. All teachers. Yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Mona, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.